Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine and doing good. Hope you liked my previous video of chapter 6 of civics. So do share this video with all your friends and subscribe my channel and hit the bell button so that you will get all the notification. So coming to chapter 6 of history that talks about the kingdoms, kings and early republic. Suppose one day you woke up and see that your grandparents all are ready to go and vote. They wanted to be the first to reach the polling booth. Did any question will rise in your mind? Yes, of course. Why they are so impatient to reach that place? Why they are so excited? Because they can choose their own rulers today. So, what we are going to study in this chapter? We are going to study about the changes in the system of how some men became rulers. Ashwamedh Yagya. Then, changes in Varna system. Then, Janpadas and Mahajanpadas. Then, changing in agriculture and taxes. Then, coming to a closer look to Magadha and Vijji. And in elsewhere, Republic of Greece. Coming to our first topic, how some men become rulers. Choosing leaders or rulers by voting is something that has become common during the last 50 years or so. How did men become rulers in the past? Some of the Rajas we read in the previous chapter were probably chosen by the Janas. Janas, the people. But around 3000 years ago, we find some changes taking place in the way in which Rajas were chosen. Some men now became recognized as Rajas by performing very big sacrifices. Now, this chapter starts with basic practice which were known as Ashwamedha. This was a ritual by a king in which a horse was let loose by him to wander freely. The horse was guarded by the king's man. If any king tried to stop the horse in his territory, the king had to battle with the king who was performing the Ashwamedha. If he allowed to let the horse pass, it was believed that he had accepted the superiority of the king who wanted to perform the sacrifice. So, in this way, the might of the king was recognized. These kings were invited to this sacrifice, which was held at the end of the entire process. All these who came brought gifts for the king. The Raja who performed Ashwamedha was a center figure in those rituals. He sat on a special throne where his wife, his son and the charioteer who runs the horse was invited. All the local men, the ordinary people who were known as Jan or Vish were also invited. They brought many gifts for them, for the king, and those who were regarded as Sudra by priest were excluded from many rituals. They were not included in ceremony process. So this was the mainly done to show the power of the king. Now next is Varna system. The last three Vedas, Shyamved, Yajurved and Atharved, were composed in this period by the Brahmin priest. So they were called later Vedic. They were called later Vedic because they were composed after the Rig Veda. In these texts, priest told about rules of the society and the rituals to be done. Many professions were practiced at the time. Priests, warriors, farmers, herders, traders, craftsmen, laborers, fishermen, forest people, fishing people, burial people. Burial peoples were the people who buried the dead bodies. Now the priests divide the society into four groups called varnas, and each varna had a different set of function. First was Brahmin. The Brahmins study, teach and perform yajnas, and they receive gifts also. Now second were Kshatriyas. They were the rulers and were expected to fight battles and protect peoples. The third were the Vaish or the Vaishya. They were expected to be a farmers, herders and traders. Both the Kshatriyas and the Vaishya could perform sacrifices. And the last were the Sudra, who had to serve the other three groups and could not perform any rituals. These varnas were initially made according to the work people did and their capability. Before what happened, the people, if Brahmin is there, but his son has chosen the work of Kshatriya, suppose he went for the battle or he worked as a shopkeeper, then he will be the Kshatriya or Vaishya. But if Kshatriya's son has chosen the work of Brahmin, suppose he is doing the work of priest, so he will be the Brahmin. And according to that, the varnas were divided, but later on, the varna were decided according to the birth. Suppose if Brahmin is there, so his son will be the Brahmin only. If Kshatriya is there, so his son will be the Kshatriya only. If one father and the mother are Brahmin, so one would automatically becomes a Brahmini. Women were also later on not allowed to study Vedas, and they were also treated like Shudra. They too were considered to have the duty to serve their husbands and families. But many people did not accept the system of Varna laid down by the Brahmins. Some kings thought they are the superior to the priest. Others felt that birth could not be a base for deciding which Varna people belongs to. Besides, some people felt that there should be no differences among people based on occupation. Others felt that everybody should be able to perform rituals, and others condemned the practice of untouchability. Also, there are many areas in the subcontinent, such as the Northeast, where social and economical differences were not very sharp and where the influence of the priests was limited. So here we have completed our this topic. For the further video, stay connected. Thank you. Have a nice day.